Welcome to this video. With an enhancement, an ABAP developer can extend the SAP standard with the ABAP programming language. The great strength of SAP ERP and SAP S4HANA is the adaptation of processes to one's own needs through customizing. But there are requirements that cannot be implemented through customizing. But with enhancement, the SAP system offers the possibility to extend the SAP standard at suitable points with the ABAP programming language. In this video, I explain what enhancements are and how they can be implemented quickly and easily in the SAP system. Enjoy this video and let's get started. So before jumping into the SAP system and showing you directly how you can implement enhancements in SAP ERP and SAP S4HANA with the programming language ABAP, I would like to explain you what an enhancement is. So basically, an enhancement is the short form of enhancement point. With this possibility of enhancement in the SAP system, you can extend the standard SAP system modification free. At certain points in the code of programs, function modules, and classes, you can implement and use enhancement points. So in other words, changes that remain even after an update and are not overwritten in the SAP system. A distinction is made between explicit and implicit enhancements. Explicit enhancement points were planned by the SAP programmer and explicitly integrated in the ABAP code. You can insert your own program code as these defined points. Implicit enhancement points, on the other hand, do not have to be planned since they automatically exist at certain points in the program. So let's talk about implicit enhancements. So implicit enhancement points are available at the following locations: beginning and end of subroutines, function modules, and methods, end of includes, end of defined or definition of a structure type or structure, and of the importing, exporting, and changing block of the declaration of local classes, and in the interface definitions of function modules and methods of global classes, and of the public, protected, and private section of local classes, and of the implementation block of local classes, and at pre and post methods of global classes. So how do I check if I can create an enhancement? So here I have opened up the function builder. It's the transaction code SE37, and here I have entered a default or a SAP function module call underscore browser, and this function module is being used to call an URL, so a website in the default browser out of the SAP GUI. But this basically doesn't matter because I just want to show you, based on this example, how to check if I can implement an enhancement based on this function module. So I click on display, and now we see the ABAP coding for this function module, and in the menu bar under edit, enhancement operations, and then show implicit enhancement options, you directly see what changes in the ABAP, or basically in the editor. So here I click on show implicit enhancement options, and here you can see that this line has been added. So at the beginning and at the end, or before the end of this function module. And here, basically, based on this line, you can see for all of these quotes that you can use an implicit enhancement point and you can add an enhancement. How to implement enhancement, I will show you in a couple of seconds. But basically, if we're going one step back, and for example, if we're typing in SEXV add prefix, it's another function module. And if you once again go to display and edit and enhancement operations and show implicit enhancement options, now you see, based on the status message, that the object function group SEXV cannot be enhanced. the package cannot be enhanced. So this is one information for you that in this function module, you can't implement enhancement and you can't enhance this function module based on the package you're using. So now I would like to show you how you can implement an enhancement. Now we're once again in the function builder, so in transaction code SE37 with the function module call underscore browser, I click on display. And then here once again under edits and then enhancement operations, show implicit enhancement options. Then you see that this line has been added and again at the end of this function module. And this is mandatory. You need to have displayed or available this line in the function module to add an enhancement. And then you click in the statement in this line, doesn't matter where you click, just click there. And then you click in this application toolbar on this button, enhance, or you could also use the key combination shift and F4. And now you see that the editor has changed. So near you have this error, you have some buttons have been added, and now you can click on this create enhancement implementation button, or you could also use the key combination control shift and F8. So, and here you have one pop-up. So you can choose a type for your enhancement. So here you can click on declaration or on code. So basically, a declaration is an unconditional call. A code is a conditional call. An unconditional call, so declaration, is a static call that is invoked independently of the client. Definition of subroutines, methods, and local classes can be implemented only in unconditional calls. A conditional call, so code in this case, is called dynamically, that is depending on the current settings of the switches. So in our case, if you want to get more information, you can also click on this info button. So here to get some nice explanation of this one, but basically because I just want to show you how you can add an enhancement, for this case I just click on code. And here basically because we want to create an enhancement implementation, you double click on the enhancement implementation. If there nothing is shown, you can also click on this create enhancement implementation, but basically I double click on this one, and now we can see that in this function module the first enhancement is being implemented based on the enhancement point or enhancement implementation set underscore ERP underscore up. And here basically you can add your coding. So for example, here you can add some functionality, you can do some prerequisites or whatever you like. And basically here you can add your coding. You have to keep in mind that the pretty printer can't be used in the enhancement, but here basically you can add your coding, what you like. You have to keep in mind that for sure you can't use some, or you can't declare variables that are being used later on this function module, but here you can create your enhancement and add your ABAP code. Now I would like to show you how you can change an enhancement, an existing enhancement. For therefore, once again, into code browser, and here we see that I have implemented two enhancements, one at the beginning and one at the end. Please subscribe ERP up. Thank you. And therefore, so just for demo purposes. So in this case, for example, we have some kind of logging scenario, but in this case, we don't log anything. So just we set this variable to this value start of call browser. And at the end, we change the value of this variable to end of call browser. And in this case, we can also change this, and therefore you have to click once again on this enhance button in the application toolbar. You could also use the key combination shift and F4. And then once again here, some buttons have been added, and therefore you have to now click on the change enhancement implementation button, or you could also use the key combination Control Shift and F6. And you have to keep in mind that you have to set the focus on the enhancement, and therefore here, for example, you can also add subscribe the YouTube channel ERP app. You can change your enhancement afterwards. Once again, you have to save it, and for sure you have to activate your enhancement to have an active version. And if you want to, you can also do it at the beginning of your enhancement. I would like to show you how you can create an own enhancement point. To show you this, I have opened up the ABAP editor, so the transaction code SE38, and now I would like to add an enhancement point into this ABAP program. So basically, this is an ABAP program that allows you to change the logon language without logging off and on again. And to do this, I go into the change mode, so I click on change. And so, for example, on line 21, I would like to add an enhancement point to give the possibility to add some validations, for example, for this variable. So I click on the line 21, and though in the menu bar, on edit and enhancement operations, then you can click on create option. And here you have to enter your enhancement point. So for example, set test ERP up, and then you have to decide whether you want to make a declaration, so an unconditional call, or a code, so a conditional call. In this case, it's a conditional call, a code. And down here, you have to select an enhancement spot. In my case, I have created already two of them. If you don't have any enhancement spot here, then you can click on this append row button, and then you have to type in your enhancement spots, for example, a short text, add a package, in my case just a temporary package $TMP, enter, and as mentioned, select the spot that you would like to use, and then click on this continue button or hit the enter key on your keyboard, and then here your enhancement point has been added. Use Control S or this save button to save your changes, and then you have an inactive status. But if you want to, you can now use this enhancement point. If you once again click in the application toolbar on enhance, or you could also use the key combination shift and F4. And then here you have this create button as we saw earlier. So you can click on the create enhancement implementation, and then you can add an enhancement implementation. So for example, set test ERP up, add a short description, just test in this case, click on this creation of enhancement button or hit the enter key on your keyboard. Here I would like to create it as a local object, or you could also enter $TMP. And then here you can add your specific ABAP code in this enhancement. And the most important thing is, please subscribe ERP. Thank you so much. Okay, great. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have learned a lot about enhancements in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. If you like this video, please click the like button, add a comment, and please do not miss to subscribe this YouTube channel to never miss great upcoming videos in the future. Thank you very much, and then see you in the next video.